Hi guys! My drone year 2022 ended with a little bang. On the last day of the year, I went to a small castle and wanted to take some epic shots with my DJI Mini 2. That finally worked, but there was also a decent crash when trying to fly through a castle gate. I misjudged the height and flew the Mini 2 against the castle wall. If you want to know how I fixed this, then stay tuned. If you like the channel, then help us to grow and subscribe. Well, the DJI Mini 2 fell from about 3 meters to the ground, but instead of going out, she started turning the propellers faster and faster. She spun across the floor and slammed into another wall a few more times. Well, I was only able to turn it off with the kill switch method. So I picked it up and quickly turned it upside down. So much for the topic, this function would be total nonsense, okay? Anyway, the drone was pretty battered. The propeller of the 2 front arms were completely broken and the top chassis had 2 large cracks. Of course, I immediately replaced the propellers, so check out this video here if you want to know how easy this is. Okay, in order to check whether the sensors and the gimbal were damaged, I did a test flight right away. Fortunately, everything was fine. What remained were these 2 big cracks on the top chassis. So I bought a new original chassis for mere 12 euro. And that's exactly what I'm going to exchange today. So let's see if it's that easy. Originally, I assumed that with these few parts, I could fix the problem. The broken drone with the 2 cracks, the new upper cover that I ordered for 12 euro, and this awesome, pretty awesome DJI screwdriver. First, of course, safety first. So I take out the battery and save the mini SD card. As you can see, the upper cover is held in place by 4 screws, 2 in the front and 2 in the back. All the screws are deep in the hole. Look, you can see it a little better with the flashlight. Okay, so let's grab the DJI screwdriver. Let's go. Well, this screw is very tight. And I cannot really lose it. I can't get the second screw off either. Wow, absolutely no chance. Okay, the back ones. Nah, the screwdriver grabs and the first rear screw loosens. Okay, tip out carefully. These screws are so small and better shouldn't get lost. Ah, pretty good. The second rear screw also moves and I can remove it. Well, since I can't get the 2 front ones out, I try to loosen the chassis from the back. I think there are a lot of little noses that I can get over my fingernail. I should be careful with the propeller arms. Okay. Pull a bit. I've got it. In my case, the chassis broke right at the front screws, which is why I got it off without unscrewing. But I need to be careful with my fingernails. Here we go. It's completely off. Now we can take a good look at the gimbal and the electronics. But why the central metal plate is scratched is pretty strange. That surprises me. As you can see, the front screws are still in place and are holding remnants of the old chassis. I now use pliers to loose the screws from above. Need to be super careful as I work close to thin cables and the gimbal and don't want to break anything. Just don't slip. Okay, since the new chassis doesn't come with a hatchback, I have to detach the old one. Luckily, it just clicks and I can remove it quickly. Okay, that's it. Here it is. Next, the 2 rear mudguards. I also have to detach this from the old upper cover. They're just glued. Here I can take the pliers and carefully pull them off. Use a little force, but don't pull too hard. Okay, and now the other side. Also just pull it off carefully. Okay, this looks good, so come on. Yeah, that's it. Then I take a pair of tweezers and carefully place them on the new upper cover. And then I put the mud protection directly on the same position of the new chassis. And the same goes for sure for the other side. Just squeeze it a little bit and finished. I'll need new glue. That stuff sticks so well I can just put it back on. Oh, that's cool. Looks like new, doesn't it? And now click the edge back in place. Not bad. Okay, that was super easy and hassle-free. Pretty nice. Looks like the new upper cover is ready. All right, then I have to reassemble it. Do you see these two noses on my new chassis? They are slightly curved. In the old cover, they were straight. Otherwise, they would not hit the counterpart. I gently straightened them with my fingernail. Okay, a quick check. Ah, and in the meantime, I was able to loosen the front screws. But that was a lot of fiddly work, I can tell you. Looks good so far, and I think I can start attaching the new upper cover. Now gradually press. I start in front. Ah, a bit of finger strength is enough. I shouldn't use force and shouldn't press too hard. Okay, then I choose a side and click everything together around the drone. Fine. Click, 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 click. Fits pretty good. Hatchback also fits perfectly and opens and closes. Amazing. And now fasten the whole thing again with the 4 mini screws. Yes, yes, I use the DJI screwdriver again. Okay, I have to turn the screws even more. Okay, works. Okay, have to push a little bit here. Ah, cool. They also grip properly at the front. I would not have expected this. Okay, this is not so handy. So if you have another screwdriver, then maybe use this one instead of the one from DJI. Okay, looks good. Guess we are done here. Hatchback closed. Ah, no, not. Put the battery in and just test it. Okay, turn on. LEDs light up. Excellent. Nice. If you like the video, smash the like button, drop me a comment below, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye bye.